Hello, it's Guy here from GD Models. Today I'm going to be doing the next stage of the Ryfield Mark 1 Tiger Tank. Since the last video, I've done all this rust weathering on this part. And if you remember rightly, I was having a bit of a problem with this seat down here. That's also on. Also, I put a bit of black, like grease on this red wheel to just make dull it down a bit, just to make it look a bit grimy. But yeah, I've literally just on all the joints, not all the joints, but the majority of them, I've added the dark rust to give it a real like rusted, weathered look. What else have I done? That's it really. Tidied it up here as well. Because if you remember, there was bits cut, the marks were cut, where I cut them off the sprue, so I just touched that up, and that's really it. I put a little bit of a wash on the seats just to give it a bit of a contrast, a bit of a different colour, you know, so it's not just like leather, it's different, slightly different shaded. There's like some darker patches and lighter patches. So, as I said, give it a bit of definition there. I haven't done any decals yet, because I'm waiting to finish this step, which I'm going to be doing today, and also I'll be doing a lot of weathering on that as well later on. But I'm very pleased with this. It's come together, and as I said, I was a bit like, am I doing too much rust here? But I just thought, you know what, the type of desire of the tank I'm going for is of the tank like after the war, and it's sort of maybe sat in the field for 20 years, you know, just the just getting the rust on it, but not too long, so there's still a bit of painting that to it as well. So I wanted to go for that type of effect rather than battle, shall we say, battle effect. But I've put all the jerry cans in it as well. So that's that stage so far. And now, today, the next stage is we've got loads of little bits of photo etch here. If you remember rightly, I mentioned, oh, I'm surprised there's not the teeth at the bottom of the turret because I was looking forward to it. I was mistaken. It's there. So what I've done, I'm not too worried about the edging here. I'm sort of a bit, I don't know. But if you look in there, I've made it look rather, I first painted X10 and then I dry brushed it with the dark colours. I'll show you the colours I've actually got so I can show you the effect I've done and how I've done it. I have brought, just trying to look for the leaflet, I bought this quite a long time ago, about a year or two ago, and I've never really looked at it. I haven't even looked at it still, this is just sort of playing around with these colours. So you've got all these colours here, some are washes, it gives you a bit of a illustration on how to do rust effect. So what I normally do is I use dark rust first, straight over the metal. I dry brush it on, try to get this more in the corners as well, and then I use the light rust, then do a dry brush of that over the top. Then I do the light wash, rust wash. Then finally, I do a very small coat brush, dry brush of the orange as well, this orange brown. So that is the only four colours I actually use to do the rust effect that I've been doing. Quite easy, just take your time really. You can't really go wrong with rust. So, back to today. after discussing the rust. What we want to do is get the stage here that I did yesterday. The only thing I did was glue this in place. And these two bits here. As you can see as well, I haven't painted the outside of this. I'm going to paint it when it's together. So we want to first off get this part, the main part, and we want to go, where does that go? Just working out which way around it goes. Okay, like that. I'll just test fit it first. Okay, so you were there. We'll get there in the end. I just don't want it to ruin it too much. So that's 90 degrees. So it's directly there. Needs to sort of, that's why, just slightly off. Right. Just making sure it all, without pushing onto a seat. Right, that's it. Just a bit of super glue so I can put that seat back on. But that is it done on that part. There we go, like that. Sorry about that. That was a bit of an awkward bit, wasn't it? It's only because I pushed my pressure down and just snapped the seat off. So, that's the actual gun turret connected. I'm just going to drop a couple of little drops of this in four places, just like almost if it's spot welding. There we go, that'll do, that'll be plenty to hold it in place. So there you go, that's the main turret. And now what I want to do is just put that down there for a second. And I've got this other little bit I've got to put on, but I've got to rust this up as well. So this is actually not finished yet. But we've got a little bit there that sits on there. Also, I'll be bringing you a BMW i8 video today. Hopefully, I've got all the bits finished. I just really need to actually upload it. Like that. So as you notice, there's a different shade. I will go over that with a paintbrush, same as on the top there. I'm just sort of like trying different methods of painting on this tank. Sort of like trying to paint as I go. Well, I'm painting the main colour and then I'm doing all the weathering and that afterwards and sort of neatening it up. So there we go. It wants to go there like that. And that's that pretty much done. That's that page done. No, it isn't. Right, I'm not going to put these on just yet, these bits of photo etch, because I want to put the gun on first with these panels that sit on the inside. Then I'll put the photo etch on. So, we want, just looking, I'll do the photo etch off the camera. I'm not a massive fan of doing photo etch. Sometimes it's not bad, but other times it can just go seriously wrong, seriously quickly. So that wants to go around there. And that's got a bush behind there. It's a bit awkward, so I was worried about. That's why I didn't want to do the photo etch just yet, you see, because the photo etch goes in here, and I didn't want to currently put the photo etch on before putting this on, because I was a bit concerned about this part. So I'm gluing this in now. Also a bit of a random one, I went to Hobbycraft today. Well, I mentioned it last night that I was going to go to a model shop this morning. And I bought the paints I needed for the Yamato, if you remember, that's why I was going there. And while I was there, I ended up picking up slightly bit of an odd random model of the Star Trek Starship Enterprise from the original series. The reason I bought that is I know obviously there's quite a few people who like Star Trek out there, so I just thought, why not? I'll give it a... I didn't see many people have build videos on it, so I was like, well, I might as well, for people who are Star Trek fans out there, I'll do that, just as a bit of a... something a little bit different. And if I enjoy it, I might do... I'm just going to take that wheel off, because I think that's going to be getting in the way while I put this bit on. So I thought, yeah, why not? I'll do a Star Trek video and for you people who like Star Trek out there. So this is going to be a bit fiddly now. So before that goes on there, we want that over that side towards the front. And we want this bit in there, like, and then just around there. Just push this down, same as before, nice and tight. Tell you what, this kit goes together really nicely, but it's no margin of error, shall we say. That's not what I wanted to do. I'm going to push it down. There we go. So I'm going to quickly run a bit of glue around there, and I'm going to run along here. And that little bit of glue I ran along the back there should give it a bit of a filler to that's a bit odd, isn't it? No, that is correct. So that's a filler. I've done that now, and I will paint over that. That's that now. Oh God, it moved. Okay. Awkward. Come on, go over there. There we go. Without damaging it. Just had to feed it through. So this bit that's been flapping around and being irritating for the past couple of weeks wants to go. Still flapping around, but it's or does it? That is the question. No, it's just on there. So you want to glue it on the face of this part, but you don't want to glue this onto there. So that just sits on there. Just move it to where it actually wants to go there. And there. And the same at the bottom. Like that. And now that's all dry, I can put the little wheel back on. Like that. There we go. So that's it. That is one. Look through there. That's one Tiger Tank turret almost finished. Obviously, I've got to do put a few boxes on the inside of the turret. I want to do a bit of weathering on that as well. But that is my first turret. Almost finished. It'll be finished by the next video. Because what I'm going to do while I go away is I'm going to look up some more photos. Finish weathering it off. Maybe give like some streaks of grime along there on the edge. And what else? So I've got to do some rust, some streaks, and the last few decals, and also the photo etch bits. These photo etch bits, as I said, bend, and they're like the different casings that go around the side for the ammunition and things like that. And I've noticed there's colours as well on that as well. So, not colours, sorry, some decals on that. So I'll put them on as well. But that's it. And hope you're enjoying this build. I know I am, definitely. And as always, if you like my videos, please hit that subscribe button and the like button. And other than that, have a great day. Happy modding. Oh, and one more thing. I put an order in for some of the first lot of stickers of my GD model stickers. I will show you. Give me a second. These ones here. There, these ones. I put out into the post today, so they should be with you hopefully sometime next week. I've ordered some more today, like a big bunch more, so if anyone else wants any of those stickers and do a bit of any model shops or whatever, please don't hesitate to give me a message on either on the comments below or join my Facebook group, and then you can private send me your email address or whatever, and I'll send you a couple of I'll send you one of the stickers across. Other than that, thank you. Also, sorry, one more thing. I do sell merchandise. I've got a few t-shirts and pens and things like that. So if you're any interested in any of the merchandise from GD Models, let me know, and I will, if I haven't already got the stock, I will make up some stock and send it out to you. Obviously, message me about how much price of certain things are. Other than that, have a great day, happy modelling, and goodbye for now.